So let's send the next question. Again, obtain a cascade and parallel realization for. So they have given the question as h of s equal to s into s plus 2, s plus 1, s plus 3, s plus 4. Okay. So now, here, they want to draw the cascade realization. Cascade means the series realization. You want to draw the structure in series manner. Okay. So here they have given the question as h of s equal to s into s plus 2 divided by s plus 1, s plus 3, s plus 4. Okay. So first, from this question itself, you can make us the form h1 of s into h2 of s, h3 of s. Okay. So here, what is h1 of s? Because for cascade structure, you want to make the question as the form h1 of s, h2 of s, h3 of s. For parallel structure, you want to make the form, you want to draw the structure parallelly. Here, you want to draw the structure seriously. So for parallel structure, you want to make it in the form h1 of s plus h2 of s plus h3 of s. Okay. So here, you want to make it in the form h1 of s into h2 of s into h3 of s. And you want to draw the structure in series manner. Okay. So from the question, you can write as s by s plus 1. This is h1 of s. And h2 of s is s plus 2 by s plus 3. And h3 of s is 1 by s plus 4. Okay. So now from the h1 of s, you can make us, if you take s as common, it become 1 by, and from denominator, s is common, what is the value remaining term? 1 plus 1 by s. So here, numerator is 1, denominator 1 plus 1 by s. The second term, h2 of s, from numerator you are taking s as common, from denominator also you are taking s as common. So what is the remaining value? 1 plus 2 by s divided by 1 plus 3 by s. Okay. And from this h3 of s, from denominator you are taking s as common. So what is the remaining value? 1 plus 4 by s. Okay. So it is h1 of s, h2 of s and h3 of s. So now we can draw the diagram. So in order to draw this diagram, you must know about the direct form 2 structure. So only I taught you direct form 2 structure in the previous video. Okay. So after knowing direct form 2 structure only, you can draw this cascade or parallel structure, because it is the combination of direct form 2 structure. Cascade structure is a combination of direct form 2 structure. So while drawing the direct form 2 structure, so this side we will draw the numerator value and this side we will draw the denominator value. Correct? Okay. So here, what is the numerator value? 1. Okay. And there is no 1 by s term. So here, this value is 0. Okay. And while drawing the denominator value, what is the value? 1 plus 1 by s. So here, the direction is opposite. So you want to denote as minus 1. If you are drawing the direction in this form, means plus 1. Okay. In this direction means it is plus 1. Or drawing in the opposite direction. So here, minus 1. If you put the arrow in this form, means you can note it as 1. Okay. Can you understand? The direction is important. So here, you are noting the direction is opposite. So denominator, 1 by s coefficient is 1. So you are putting minus 1. Okay. Next, you want to draw h2 of s. While drawing h2 of s, here also, so it is the numerator value. Numerator is 1 and 2. And while drawing the denominator, it is in opposite direction. So minus 1, minus 3. If you are putting direction in this form, means it is plus 1. So it is opposite direction. So it is minus 1. So here also h3 of s. Okay. Drawing h3 of s. So it is the numerator value. So the constant term is 0. And the coefficient of 1 by s is 1. While drawing the denominator, constant term is 1. And the coefficient of 1 by s is minus 4. Okay, so it is the cascade realization. That is the series structure of h1 of s, h2 of s and h3 of s. Okay, so next is the parallel realization. Drawing the parallel realization, so I said you want to make it in the form h1 of s plus h2 of s plus h3 of s. Okay. So here we are making, for making h1 of s plus h2 of s plus h3 of s, we need to solve only in the partial fraction method. So we are solving the given question in partial fraction method. So you can write this question as a by s plus 1 plus b by s plus 3 plus c by s plus 4. So from this you want to find the value of a, b and c using partial fraction method. So first we can find the value of a. How you will find the value of a? A is h of s into, what is the denominator value of s plus 1? So you want to multiply that value s plus 1. So you want to substitute the s value as minus 1. That is s plus 1 equal to 0. So s equal to minus 1. Okay. And now you can substitute. So a h of s value is s into s plus 2. S plus 1, s plus 3, s plus 4 into s plus 1 value. And 2 value are get cancelled. And remaining value in here, In the place of s, you want to substitute minus 1. So, you got the value a is minus 1 by 6. Okay. Similarly, in the same way, you want to find the value b. So, b h of s into, so the denominator value s plus 3. So, you want to multiply with s plus 3. You want to substitute ss minus 3 because s plus 3 equal to 0. So, s equal to minus 3. In the place of s, you want to substitute as minus 3. So, you got b value as minus 3 by 2. Similarly, in c also, you want to substitute and you got the c value was 8 by 3. Okay. So, you got a, b, c value. And now, substitute in our h of s value, what is the a? Minus 1 by s and b is minus 3 by 2 and c is 8 by 3 divided by s plus 1, here s plus 3 and c by s plus 4. Okay. So, now solve this. So, take s as common here. So, you got 1 plus 1 by 6, sorry, 1 by s here. If you take s as common, 1 plus 3 by s. Here, if you take s as common, 1 plus 4 by s. Okay. So, now you can take this s to the numerator. So, you got 1 by s minus 1 by 6 into 1 by s divided by 1 plus 1 by x. And here, minus 3 by 2 into 1 by x divided by 1 plus 3 by s. Here, 8 by 3 into 1 by s divided by 1 plus 4 by s. So, you can take this as h1 of s value. This is h2 of s value. This is h3 of s value. So, we got in the form h1 of s plus h2 of s plus h3 of s. So, we need, in order to solve the parallel structure, we need the in the form h1 of s plus h2 of s plus h3 of s. Okay. So, it is h1 of s, it is h2 of s and this is h3 of s. So, now, while drawing the h1 of s structure, in the numerator, you didn't have any constant value. Thus, so that term is 0. This side, you will draw the numerator value and only 1 by s is there is only 1 by s. If it is 1 by s squared means you want to draw 2 delays here. There is only 1 by s. So, you want to draw only 1 by s. Here, there is no the constant term. Only the coefficient of 1 by s, there is minus 1 by 6. And denominator 1, it is in opposite direction. So, you want to put minus 1. So, if it is in this direction means you want to put as positive 1. And what is the coefficient of 1 by s? 1. So, it is in opposite direction. So, you want to put minus 1. Okay. So, here also same thing. H2 of s. Okay. And h2 of s minus 1 in this side denominator. And here the coefficient of 1 by s is minus 3 want to put. Here it is the numerator value. There is no constant term. The coefficient of 1 by s is minus 3 by 2. And here in h3 of s in the numerator value. Numerator value there is no constant term. Only there is a coefficient of 1 by s. So the coefficient of 1 by s is 8 by 3. And the denominator, the coefficient is constant term is minus, here direction is opposite, so you are putting minus 1, okay, and here the coefficient of 1 by s is minus 4, okay, so we got h1 of s, h2 of s, h3 of s, so h1 of s plus h2 of s, so you want to add these two blocks, that is h1 of s is added with h2 of s, so you want to draw parallelly because it is a parallel structure. If it is a series cascade means you want to draw in series manner. So, it is a parallel structure. So, you want to draw it parallelly and you want to combine each block with adder plus. Okay. So, h1 of s is added with h2 of s. h2 of s is added with h3 of s. And input is x of s and output is y of s. So, this is the structure of parallel form. Okay. That is, you want to draw three blocks, that is h1 of s, h2 of s, h3 of s in parallel form. Okay. So, it is the block diagram of given h of s value. Can you understand? So, it is important if it is in opposite direction means you want to change the sign. If it is in same direction means you want to put as the positive sign. Okay.